Kobo 360, as you know, is a digital supply chain platform. We are building what we call GLOS, a Global Logistics Operating System, which is a digital infrastructure that will power trade and commerce across Africa, Middle East, and other frontier markets. So the plan, of course, is to find the right talent, assemble the right talents. We've started already. There will be announcements that we'll make towards end of the year on the new additions across every market, especially within the core market, which is Nigeria, and also in the Africa region, in a market we call Africa region, right? So that's the key thing. Technology, deepening our technology is also in the other part of things, right? We're moving close to 50 engineers by the end of this year, right? So really bringing people who will build that, that's a blockchain powered GLOS to be able to truly connect trade and commerce across these frontier markets, where you're adding the insurance, the logistics, the diesel, the spare parts, the financing, all these things into a super platform that is able to solve the challenges we have in supply chain. Yeah, so I'm optimistic about the APAPA situation. It's getting better, right? But we haven't gotten it right because it needs an infrastructure play and also a technology play. The infrastructure being that you need physical roads that are good. Of course, the Dangote Group and other people are also constructing that road today. It's slow, but it's ongoing. Of course, the technology part is how do you organize the traffic of trucks, right, going inside the port, in and out of the port. That's where we built a call-up system, a digital call-up system that is powered by USSD that allows drivers to queue on our platform, and then they get called, they get SMS. And any law enforcement, any part of Nigeria can actually stop a truck and verify that that particular truck is supposed to be on the road, right? Of course, you have the other deeper issues which the government need to solve in terms of making sure that port operators have holding bay. Holding bay is common across every port in the world, where a port operator must hold their containers outside of the port. Right, that means that trucks that are carrying empty can't come inside the port every time, so they can come in on a weekend or certain days when their ship is actually around, so that they just can pick up those things. So, but I think once you have road and there's kind of a technology, I think the other part becomes a little bit easier for government to be able to say, okay, this inefficiency we can just nab it quickly. So the government was confused on these type of platforms, right? Because for government, they look at things that will solve strategic problems in the economy. Governments are big, they can't focus on everything. But today, as we start really gathering interesting data, right? Data on the road conditions of all the major roads we operate in across 5 countries, right? As you start really making a dent in the supply chain industry, as we are partnering with people to build what we call driver support centers that can pack 1,500 trailers and 300 sleeping beds for drivers, 6 of them across Nigeria. Yeah, the government start really getting interested, because if you have those type of infrastructure, then drivers are able to go off the road and then they're able to rest at intervals, meaning that you're going to reduce the 1.2 million deaths in road accident in Nigeria, potentially by 50% or more. So what we should aim for is to have one big platform, digital logistics platform, that basically has APIs, right, for different parts of the economy, right? So, but this powers all supply chain and even transport, right? Are we, because that's also when government, that's when we start solving the problem in the country. If we're just fragmented and not partnering, you are not able to have the scale to really solve the problem in the economy, right? And government only looks at things that have scale, right? Because of course they have a lot of things on their plate. But imagine in next 5 years, right, if this continent can have a gigantic digital supply chain or logistics platform that has transport and logistics and delivery and all those things in one, then it becomes a little bit easier for government to create policies, right? Because there is scale there, right? They can know exactly what they need to create and they can do that. So I think that that should be something that we should see. And Kobo is also very open to a lot of these partnerships, right? And also trying to see if we can bring people together as well in future to see how we can really power our continent. Obi Ozor, co-founder and CEO of Kobo 360, a digital supply chain platform. You are watching Business Day Tech Bridge.
Thank you.